Well, Gavin, just first and foremost, just reflect on the season, how you feel about your performance this year.
You know, personally, it was a decent year for me. However, you know, you never take those accolades when you have a team behind you. It's not an individual game. You know, the season was a success for us. We had a great regular season. We were right where we needed to be. You know, and unfortunately, it's the way these playoffs work. If you don't bring your A game, you don't play the best game of that you can bring that particular day, you lose and you're out. It's not a series. It's not one of those things. So today, we were not our best, no doubt about it. I don't know if we had 10, 11 goals, whatever it was, but 11 goals is very tough to win a game against a team like Minnesota. They came in and took it from us, and I'm sure we had the opportunities, but we didn't bury at the times, and I'll blame the offense for that loss.
All right, switching gears briefly, just talk about Steve Gullett as an owner of this franchise and your impressions of him.
Well, if he was our owner, I'd be good. General manager, yes. No, just kidding. Sorry, I don't mean to bust your balls. It's you know, he puts together. You know, he's a puzzle maker, and it's hard to take all the pieces from different teams. You know, you have to be able to foresee how the team's going to gel. It's not just the type of player; it's a character of each player that we're bringing into the dressing room. And he sees not only good players but good people, and it makes it so much easier to gel that way. You know, he's kind of a mastermind behind the puppetry show, if you will. And you know, he once again did another great job putting together a very competitive team. You know, we let him down. It's a tough feeling right now, but. You know, I hate saying it, but there's always next year, right? And I think we built a good foundation and a few other pieces to the puzzle, and we'll be right back where we need to be.
How do you guys bounce back and get ready for next season?
You know, right now, you know, we had some injuries, and it wasn't our best game. It's tough to end on a note like that. You lick your wounds. You try to forget. But it's also a lesson. You can't forget the lesson, but you have to forget the game. We go back and we work as hard as we possibly can in the off season with our respected teams when we go back, and hopefully training camp comes around and we come back with a little bit more hunger. And we started the year off well, didn't end it well, so we gotta somehow get our the feeling back of winning all the way through.
Thank you.
Gavin, just one from me. Did clinching early, did knowing you were in the playoffs, then knowing you had a home game, did that have any negative effect down the stretch?
I don't think so. You know, that was our goal. Once you get the goal, I don't think we laid off the gas. I think we just ran into some tough situations. We had numerous injuries that kind of held us back. It showed a little bit today. But at the same time, there's no excuses. You know, you lose your four top players. You lost John Grant for a couple of games. You lost me for a couple of games. You lost John Sullivan for a couple of games. You lost Mac Allen for a couple of games. If you have a healthy lineup all the way through, Jared Park for a couple of games. You know, those are all starters in any single team. Injuries are part of the game, but it was tough for us to take so many at the end of the year. You know, that's a tough obstacle to overcome. You know, we did our best with what we had, and unfortunately we got everybody back, but we weren't 100% healthy today. We tried battle, and I'm proud of the guys for battling, but at the same time, we lost the battle today.
Gavin, thank you.
All right, thanks, guys.